Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jay. If this is your first time here, welcome. So today I have a comparison video between two of my current flip wallets, and one of the wallets is from Chanel. And here I have the French flip wallet in a caveat leather with the silver hardware. And I will be comparing that with my Louis Vuitton Victorine wallet in a demi Aben print. Now I have videos on each one separately where I go into more details, so I will make sure to link that for you. But for this comparison video, I'm just gonna give you an overall of each one, give you pricing, talk about pros and cons, and my overall experience with each one. So let's go ahead and get started with the Chanel, as this was the first one that I got out of the two. This French wallet currently retails for $775 US. This comes in this color. I've also seen it in black, dark navy, and I believe a fuchsia. This wallet on the back features the zip wallet, or zip pocket rather. And when you open it up, you'll find the silver snap closure. And inside, this has 6 credit card slots, 3 on each side. And then it has the 2 slots here for your bills. And the Louis Vuitton demi Aben retails for $540 US. And this comes in different prints, and it also comes in different leathers. And from my understanding, the monogram Bernini leather is the most expensive, and that retails for $675 US. When you open up this gorgeous wallet, you'll find the red throughout and the gold snap closure. Inside here, you'll find the zip pocket with the extra leather. This one also features 6 credit card slots, 3 on each side. And this just has 1 slot for your bills. Now, currently I am using this, which I will talk about in a second. So let me just talk first about wear and tear for each one. This one I got over the summer, and I have to tell you that in the video I had mentioned that after using it for a couple of months, I found that I had an ink stain, and it was black, and it was also a little bit damaged in the corners here. And you guys had actually told me to go back to Neiman's, which is where I purchased the wallet, and find out if they can do anything about it. When I went to the store, I had already, you know, surpassed the policy, which I believe is 60 days, which I honestly feel that it's great, because if you're gonna buy Chanel, Louis, and if you can pick it up like at a Neiman's, it's better to purchase it there versus the independent stores of like Chanel, Louis, where you only have 14 days. But aside from that, when I explained to them what happened and the wear and tear on the corner, they pretty much said, we can't take it back. You know, we can't resell it. There's nothing we can do about it. So that particular day, I had actually purchased something from a different designer, and the gentleman I was talking to, I had explained to him what happened at Chanel, and he gave me a great company that was actually in New Jersey, which is where I purchased this. And he said, everybody thinks that they send everything to Paris and you know, Italy to get fixed, and they actually send it to this shop in New Jersey, and they're very well known. They've been around for a long, long time. They will take care of the problem. And sure enough, I went there over the weekends, you know, and they took care of it. And I actually took this wallet, as well as my Pochette Matisse, because I had had to get the fichetta fixed. I had stained it with hand sanitizer. And between that and this, and you know, making sure that whatever ink stain I had was removed and that they fixed the corner, they charged me $90, and I was super, super excited. I was very, very happy, very, very pleased. But because I can tell you that you can't see anything. Everything is perfection now, everything. The corners look great. The ink spot is gone. I am very, 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 very happy. So if you guys are interested, definitely let me know. I have no problem giving you guys the company information. They were awesome, so absolutely love it. So when it comes to wear and tear, I just have to say that for the Chanel so far was a con. However, if it wasn't for me getting that fixed, I would probably still say is a con. So now I guess is a con pro, if that makes any sense, just because I'm happy with the results by doing that extra step. When it comes to the Victorine wallet, I have to say wear and tear, there is nothing for me to report. I have to say that I am very, very happy with it. The corners look amazing. There is nothing that I find that, you know, it's scratched or the leather, the print rather, is messed up, or, you know, even the buttons, everything is in perfect condition so far. So I am very happy because I'm still using this, you know, compared to this using it for only 2 months. I've been using this now for three months, and I'm probably going to use it until the end of the year. So wear and tear so far, I'm going to say that the Victorine wins. Let's just talk about security, because that to me is important. If you're someone who you know, lives in an area where it's very busy, you take public transportation, you know, you don't like people looking over your shoulder, or, you know, like if you're at the supermarket or whatever it is, I think that when it comes to that, I'm gonna say that the Louis Vuitton is probably the best. And the reason for that is because with the Chanel, you have to open the wallet in order for you to get whatever it is you need to get out, whether that's credit card or bills, where I find that with the Louis Vuitton, you don't have to do that. I mean, you can if you want to, but honestly, let's just say you're using a credit card all the time, all you have to do is just put the credit card here on the top, and then all you know, you have to do when you go and purchase whatever it is, you can just take it out like so. You don't really have to open it. So I think when it comes to security, you're definitely gonna, you know, enjoy using the Victorine wallet. Now, that being said, let's just talk about just comfort and access of in and out of each wallet. I'm gonna have to say that Chanel is probably the best, because I cannot tell you how stiff this Victorine wallet is. I had talked about it in the video, and I don't get it, which is a reason why I am still using this wallet, because, you know, for whatever months now, I still have to kind of struggle taking things out, which is not a bad thing, but it is annoying. If I'm at a place where I need to go, whether I'm at a supermarket or I just need to purchase something quickly, I find that that is kind of a problem. If you're someone like myself who has natural nails, I'm going to tell you that you got to be careful with it, because you can easily break a nail. And there's been times where I had to use another credit card to put it underneath this other credit card in order for me to take it out. So I don't like that at all. And, you know, the Chanel one is just super, super smooth. I mean, I used this for 2 days and it was a little bit stiff, but you can easily get in and out of the wallet, and I absolutely love it. So for that reason, I'm just gonna say that the Chanel definitely beats that for sure. Another thing that I have to mention is that if you're someone who likes to keep their bills look nice and neat and organized, or if you like to have smaller bills in front of the, you know, larger bills, I'm gonna say that Chanel definitely is the winner, because I cannot tell you how easy it is for you to just organize your bills here in the front and then have your larger ones in the back, and your bills look amazing. But when it comes to the Victorine wallet, and I had mentioned this, the bills just really get wrinkled, and here I have a dollar bill and this is what your bills look like. Like, why is that happening? I don't get it. And if you're someone who uses, you know, a laundry card, or you gotta pay for parking and you don't use a credit card, you constantly have to do this. And for that, I don't like it. For me, that's kind of annoying. So I don't like that. All right, so another thing that I wanted to talk about was the zipper pockets. And comparing the two, I find that the Chanel one is probably the best, because you can definitely add credit cards in here if you like extra bills or a credit card or paperwork and coins, versus the Louis Vuitton one that I don't think that you have that much space. Right now, I just have like a couple of cards in there, but I really can't add anything more. So I think that the Chanel one is better. And another thing too is space in your handbag. So comparing these two side by side, you know, the Chanel one is definitely taller, but when it comes to the depth, I find that they're pretty much the same. And the other thing that I wanted to talk about is pricing. Now you're looking about a difference of $235, where, you know, if you're gonna go with the Victorine and say you wanna do the Vernis leather, then you're looking about a $100 difference. So a couple of things that you have to consider, but overall, I think that both of them are great. They serve different purposes in my lifestyle. When I'm busy and hectic and I really don't wanna fuss too much with wallets, I would probably say that I would rather go with the Victorine, whereas I think that if I'm just gonna be traveling or I'm just gonna go out for a weekend and I have time to kind of relax, I'm gonna go ahead and take my Chanel wallet. All right, guys, so that is everything that I have for a comparison video. I hope that this was helpful. If you liked this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet already. And if you have these wallets, please feel free to comment down below. And as always, thank you so much, and I'll see you soon. Thanks, guys. Bye.